Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Cathedral. I want to have a special welcome to any guests who are with us this afternoon as we finally get a chance to dedicate and bless our organ we've had for a little bit of time. And we're so privileged to have with us Ray Lucente, who has been here before 30 years ago when we did this for the first organ that was up there. And we, of course, moved that organ to the chapel. So whatever we did the first time worked really well, so we're going to do the same thing again, right? Because that organ has been great, and this new one has been wonderful too. We have a blessing for the organ to begin with. You know, the church has blessings for everything. We have a whole book of it. So we will begin with the book of blessings for the organ, and then we'll invite Ray to guide us to this wonderful recital that he has planned. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the love of God our Father, the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the comfort of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, we've come together to bless this new organ, installed so that the celebration of the liturgy may become more beautiful and solemn. The purpose of music in the liturgy is above all to give glory to God and to lead us to holiness. Thus, the music of the organ wonderfully expresses the new song that Scripture tells us to sing to the Lord. To sing this new song is to live rightly, to follow God's will eagerly and gladly, and by loving one another to carry out the new commandment that Jesus gave us. Let us pray. Lord God, your beauty is ancient and ever new. Your wisdom guides the world in right order, and your goodness gives the world its variety of splendor. The choirs of angels join together to offer their praise by obeying your commands. The galaxies sing your praises by the pattern of their movement that follows your laws. The voices of the redeemed join in a chorus of praise to your holiness as they sing to you in mind and heart. We, your people, joyously gather in this church, Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception. We wish to join our voices to the universal hymn of praise, so that our song may rise more worthily to your majesty. We present this organ for your blessing. Grant that its music may lead us to express our prayer and praise in melodies that are pleasing to you. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going to take holy water, and from down there, up, go up there, and then I'll bless them look thoroughly later on. I want to get everything wet right now, okay?
Yes, the Lord bless this organ and all the music that flows from it. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
case, my thanks to Father Hank, and of course, your bishop was the rector here then. It was just Father Joe when I was here the last time, and it's kind of a homecoming for me in many ways, as I said to Father. I really felt very much at home coming back here, because I felt so welcomed by then Bishop Corrado, and then Father Joe, and all the people that I met back then. And of course, Brian. I want to thank Brian as well. Brian, like me, is one of those people who will be sitting at a console until they can no longer climb onto the bench. And that's kind of how things are. The piece I just played, which is the CS Lang Tumatum, is a piece of English organ music. I am a particular devotee of English organ music, so I usually try to open with something like that. The next piece on the program is really an arrangement of a hymn. Gaelic air, you'll know the hymn right away, I won't even have to tell you. What it will show you on the instrument is a little bit of some of the colors. You'll hear the oboe, you'll hear some interesting flute sounds as well. And Keith Chapman was the Wanamaker organist. I've been there 43 years as an assistant at the largest fully playing musical instrument in the world, actually. And Keith wrote a number of pieces of music for that organ. This is one of them. For those of you who are organists, I'm sure perhaps we have a few organists in the crowd, which leads me to the question why I'm not one up here. In any case, he really, like most of us, even a concert artist, was a church musician. And I think it's kind of where all our heart is. You know, when I do a dedication like this, my goal is to try to maybe add a little bit more understanding to you as the congregation and the community of the purpose of this instrument. This instrument is a tool. It is Ryan's tool, it is your tool, it is Father's tool. It's everyone's tool to support the worship and prayer life, not only the congregation, but the community. So that's why a lot of the music that I pick for programs like this is focused on that particular philosophy. Gaelic air is another piece like that. As I say, you'll know the hymn right from the first four notes that I play. And for those of you who are organists, if you've ever played Keith's music, it sounds a lot easier than it is. It's unfortunate that you won't have an opportunity to see that twice during this piece, this instrument, by the way, is three keyboards and a pedal board. And twice I will be playing two of the keyboards with one hand and the third keyboard with the other hand, whilst playing something totally different in the pedals. Keith was good at trying, I think it was sort of a sense of humor. But in any case, it's an interesting piece, and I think you'll enjoy this treatment of a very well-known.
Just for clarification, Mr. Lucente's first name is not Ray, it's Rudy. Yes. I messed that up twice. I just took him off to say Ray either way. Anyway, I apologize.
That's okay, Father Hank is a pastor, which means he gets to do whatever he wants. And besides, Bishop Strickland is here, he can really get away with anything he wants. you'll hear a lot of writings. I'm sure you've heard this going at one point or another. The problem is, generally speaking, especially if it's an entrance, the big problem is that at wedding rehearsals, everyone is very solemn about the whole thing and getting used to the space and you know, marching up the aisle in some sense of order. But on the day of the wedding, especially if there are children involved, everyone is sort of really sort of torqued and you know, really kind of ready to roll. And the wedding party, and I'm sure the organists will know what I mean by this, they look like the Boston Marathon going up the aisle. So the organist is sitting there trying to play a piece of music that has a beginning and the end. And the problem is you can't get much past the middle. So this Psalm 19 by Marcello, this will probably be one of the few times that you'll get a chance to hear the whole piece. Because there isn't anyone coming up the aisle to get married, at least not that I've been told. So in any case, this is the Psalm 19. And this will be a different sound from the organ. It's going to be a much fuller sound. And you won't hear necessarily some of those quiet voices, flutes, and like you heard Bobo before. But you will hear more of a trumpet sound, but used in a different way than it was in the trumpet tune. So this is the Marcello Psalm 19. Very, very interesting. a wonderful man, a wonderful composer, a very spiritual person. He enjoyed Jane and visited my wife and I a number of times. And so I'm delighted to be replaced. Now, this piece is very meditative. Okay? It's for, you'll hear several different types of flutes, and it's got a little middle section that kind of gets a little bit more introspective, as it were, and then it goes back to more of a meditation. So, for those of you who like quiet organ music, this is your piece. Thank you. Thank you. You can't ever go wrong with your traffic angle, and there's no question about that. So the Royal Fireworks Suite is another one of those pieces that is semi-orphan, as I call them, because on occasion I played this for a wedding, not often, because for the most part, most couples do not know the piece, yet it makes for a very lovely festive overture, as it were. So this, of course, is the beginning of the suite that George Frederick Handel wrote. Royal Fireworks, this the way that took place was the grass loop clips on a barge going down the river, and playing this, and fireworks going off while they were playing music that he wrote. So now I will tell you, for those of you who like loud organ music, this is your piece. And so you realize, of course, that all of you are could really be separated into two groups. We could actually have one group on one side of the church and one group on the other. You have those of you who came because you like organ music, you like to listen to organ music, or you are in some way connected with the organ. That's the first half. The second half of the group are those of the people who are dragged, kicking, and screaming by the first half to come to the organ concert. So that's organ, organ concert audiences are always separated into two groups. So, but in any case, that's why I try to pick things that sort of, appeal to both sides of the group. So, in any case, for those of you who like slightly more festive organ music, this is your piece. Thank you. some music, some of the music, but very little. A number of suites for organ, and there's one particular suite that he wrote that this little menuetto, it really kind of attracted me because it's good for a program like this, and I'll tell you why. You'll hear some sounds from the organ that are kind of a little bit more interwoven than you've heard before, and also there's a middle section that has strings, and then it goes back to pretty much the, what it was in the beginning, so it's kind of an A, B, A construction. And I found that Ireland's music is very listenable. What I like about it is it's happy, it kind of, it's very, very subtle, it's a for lack of a better way to put it. And it's kind of one of those things, it's comfort food for the ear as well. So this is not Ireland's menuetto impromptu. Thank you. One of the features of this instrument is called Genesis voices. What these are several hundred of what could kind of collectively be called bells and whistles, as a matter of fact. And at least what I'm using for is more bells and whistles. But this next piece was written by Richard Curtis. Richard Curtis was the famed director of music at San Francisco's Grace Cathedral. He was also Keith Chapman's mentor and teacher. So in a sense, as Keith Chapman was my teacher, Kimmel serves music? And I said, sure. I mean, I was going to leave a congregation without an organist. So I got there, and the organ was just lovely. It had this lovely trumpet on it, and I thought, well, you know, several things happened. I forgot my music bag, so I had no music bag. In my music bag was my playing glasses, so that means I can see the organ in front of me, except for the bottom of my bifocals. And I thought, well, okay. I kind of know that David Johnson trumpeted. David Johnson, an American composer, and he wrote books of trumpet tunes. And the running joke in Philadelphia is I'm one of the organists in Philadelphia that plays most every trumpet tune known to man. That is not, by the way, absolutely true. I do play a lot of them. But in any case, so I thought, well, I'll do the Johnson trumpet tune. Now, like most of the pieces that I play like that, I take some liberties with it. I add add extra notes to it, just a little bit of a phrase here, maybe a little term there, and so I kind of went through and did that. So after the service, and it went very well, after the service, these two ladies came up to me, and one lady says to me, I'm a member of this congregation, and we're delighted to have you, and thank you for coming, and it was nice of you to step in at the last minute. And this nice lady has just joined our church, and this is her first Sunday here. She just moved to this area. So the other lady says to me, I was fascinated by your treatment of the Johnson trumpet tune. And I thought to myself, who is this person? No one knows this piece. And she's probably some professor of music in some major school somewhere, and she's going to, you know, rip me up and down for changing the music. And I said, I forgot my glasses, forgot my music, but I enjoy David Johnson's music, and I really enjoy this trumpet tune. And I said, I hope that was okay with you. I said, obviously, you know the piece. She said, well, I should. I'm David Johnson's daughter. So before I play the piece, I absolutely want everybody to fess up if there's anybody here who's related to David Johnson. Because that, what were the chances? I should have bought a lottery ticket that day. What were the chances of David Johnson's daughter not only being in the congregation, but in that congregation for the very first time? And I'm just playing just at the last minute. So, in any case, more or less the way David Johnson wrote it, here is his trumpet tune. This is particularly for those of you who are organists and have books. This is the one in D major.
Thank you.
So myself and Mr. Peter Conti, who is the head organist, represented by him, to come and experience the instrument and have an opportunity to play. So he sits down and he takes out of his briefcase a copy of Percy Fletcher's Fountain Reverie. Now, you need to know that Fountain Reverie was out of print when I was born. And that's a long time ago. So, in any case, I have been trying to find it for years. Peter Conti had been trying to find it for years. It's out of print. You can't find it anywhere, and nobody that I knew had a copy. Some of the people who played for memories, they do it years ago, I don't know what they did with the music. So here, this person had a copy of the music. So I can tell you that we very quickly made sure that we acquired copies of the music to the Fountain Forever. And I'm also on staff at what's called Longwood Gardens, and Longwood Gardens is the estate of Pierre DuPont, as in Chemical Company, in Pennsylvania, just also the Delaware border, as a matter of fact, in Pennsylvania and Delaware, the airport. So, in any case, Longwood Gardens, of course, is 1,100 acres of beautiful plantings and conservatories and a wonderful, actually the largest organ, pot organ ever built in a dry process. So I frequently, since they had the big fountain show, and they used to redid the fountains, I had resurrected Fountain Reverie. And it's really such a lovely piece that I thought I would include it in today's program because I thought you might enjoy hearing this. And again, for those of you who like kind of meditative soft organ music, this is a piece you will like. Thank you. Several years ago, I went up to Yale University to visit Professor Thomas Murray up there. Thomas Murray is considered one of the finest transcription players ever on planet Earth. And he's a revered professor of organ and just an incredibly wonderful man and just very personable. And so I had the privilege of being able to just do it. One of the privileges and the perks of where playing on an organ is that I get to meet people like Tom Murray and visit them. So, and I might also add that the answer to the question of why I think the finest pipe organ is anywhere in the world that I have ever played, the pipe organ in Woolsey Hall at Yale University ranks number one with me and most any organist you talk to is playing. So it was really a privilege to be able to go up there again and encounter that instrument. Professor Murray took me to his church where he had, he wanted me to see the organ, and he said, this is really nice, it was just rebuilt, and he said, I've been helping him out, playing once in a while, so up in Haven, Connecticut. And so he sat down and he started to play, and he stopped, and I'm like, what is that? He said, oh, it's this piece called Stately Marsh by this guy named Galbraith. I said, never heard of him. He said, neither had I. Now, Thomas Murray not hearing about J. Lamont Galbraith would be like you or I never hearing about Thomas Edison, as it were. So, in any case, I was really surprised. I mean, there can't possibly be a composer that Thomas Murray does not know. And I said, well, how did you come upon the piece? He said, well, he said, somebody sent me a handwritten copy of it. It's not ever, apparently, it's not published or whatever. So, he said, I'll fax you a copy. He said, I don't even know where they got it. So he sent me a copy, and I thought, you know, this is kind of a cool piece. It's a good closer for a dedication concert because it does use all of the organ, there's no question about it. It's even got a little bit of section and things of that nature. It really kind of wanders about, as it were. So, so I chose to finish up my program today with the Stately March by J. Lamont Galbraith, after which hopefully Father will lead us in a closing prayer and blessing, and I will wander my way downstairs. Salty is doing that. But in any case, thank you again for coming. I want to thank church organs in Dallas, and Mr. Dale Johnson, who's here on the company, is actually sitting right behind me. He's here. He's up here in the loft with me. You can't see me hiding. So, also a phenomenal organist himself, and their company is just first rate, and they've done such a great job here for you as they did with the other instrument, which is now in your chapel. I believe I got a chance to see that earlier today. So, things are obviously progressing here in Tyler, and again, thank you for having me. It's really a privilege to come here. I feel very much at home and hope I have an opportunity to come back. And so this is Stately March by J. Lamont Galbraith. Oh, and I might also mention one other thing, that can we have a round of applause for Brian, because you're so lucky to have him.
Brian again for organizing. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord is worthy of all praise. May he give you the gift of striving to sing a new song to him with your voices, your hearts, and your lives, so that one day you may sing that song forever in heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Thank you all very much.